Right now, there are only three rather stable Muslim countries that you can call the castles of Islam: Turkey, Saudi Arabia, and Pakistan. But unfortunately, there's a lot of stuff happening against these countries, and they themselves are making so many mistakes that it's getting worse day by day. And according to a hadith, we know that during the towards the end of the times, there would be the time when we would lose Constantinople, that's Turkey, and there would be a very bad situation and a very worse conditions in Medina and Makkah too. So basically what we can say based on these ahadith that we would lose both Turkey and Saudi Arabia. There would be no hold of Muslims in these two countries. So you are right, there must be something that needs to be done to unite and strengthen these three countries, including Pakistan. The first thing and the most important one is to be careful about with the tongues. That's the most important thing, because there are multiple ahadiths of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam where we know that when Sahaba asked Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Khatamun Nabiyyin Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that what should we do in such a scenario in the time of fitan, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, one should become the mat of his own house. That one should not leave the house, should not talk to people about fitna, should not indulge himself in fitna. And in other ahadiths tell us that one should just move to the mountains and have some goats rather than involving himself in fitna. So at the time of fitan, our responsibility is to just shut up and not talk about anything. Just be careful about yourself and save your own iman. For example, what happened in Libya, it was such a painful scenario. I happened to be the one watching all the news live back then. It was such an unfortunate situation that it was all dissent coming from the normal people that you call the Arab Spring. Apparently they were normal people, but they were a bunch of kids shouting and causing dissent among people, a lot of hue and cry and chaos, and like blaming the governments for the bad things. I'm sure there were many bad things, but this is no basis for dissent. There's no basis for rebellion. But what happened eventually, that it got so worse that it was chaos everywhere and fighting and fitna everywhere in Libya. And then the international media, so-called tycoons, big crocodiles, whatever you call them, they brought some of those so-called young leaders on camera and promoted them even more. And they were able to manipulate them towards their own liking, towards the liking of the West. And finally, it was the situation that that news must be available on the internet still, that it was the Libyan people apparently that who called that they needed NATO support over there against their own government. Because of all that dissent and rebellion and all that chaos and all that hue and cry, what happened? See, whose government is there in Libya? There's no government. It's all fitna over there, all killing, people dying out of hunger, chaos, killing, murders, homicides. Why? Because the people sat and made them think that they are doing the right thing by stopping the government and the people from doing the bad things. But they ended up in the worst of the worst conditions because they defied Allah's orders that Atiyu Allah wa Rasula wa Ulul Amri Minkum. They defied Allah's orders that you have to obey Allah, His Prophet, last Prophet, and also the people who are ruling you. The best you can do is you can tell them to do the right things in a very nice manner, but you cannot rebel against them. It's not allowed. And I took your question to a stretch, but I think that's the best thing we can do. Because right now, what I see is a lot of people to gain views and gain some attention and whatnot. They're talking about the bad things happening in Saudi Arabia. Yeah, you should talk about the bad things happening in Saudi Arabia especially. But you should not, you must not talk about those things in a fashion that causes dissent and a sense of rebellion among the people. And Saudi Arabia is a very, very sensitive place. It's not like Turkey, it's not like Dubai, it's not like Pakistan. It's a very, very sensitive place. Suppose it's the situation of Hajj or Umrah. And a lot of people from all over the world are there and there's a sense of dissent, a sense of rebellion within them. And something happens over there, what would happen? It would be all fitna, all killing, and it would be very bad over there. So everyone opening their mouths, everyone talking about the scenarios over there especially, they must be very, 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 very careful. And they must tell people to think of those things that bad, think of those things that not the right things to do, but they must also tell people to never ever involve themselves in any form of fitna. This is the job of the government to cure those things, to fix those things, to not involve themselves in things that are against Islam. But it is our job to make sure we cooperate with the governments in terms of peace, in terms of law and order. So that's the best thing that can be done at the time of fitna. This is the time of fitna. This is the time I'm foreseeing a lot of bad things, may Allah save us, that might happen very soon. That's the best thing that we can do to strengthen our governments. Because in our attempt to fix our own governments, in an attempt to secure the sanity of the place, we would end up making it worse. So the best thing at the time of this fitna is to be careful with our tongues and talk more about peace and solidarity and look over the things as much as we can and talk about the common things, talk about the peace, because it's going to be fitna anyways. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from having our input in that fitna. And may Allah save us from every citizen and involving any form of dissent, rebellion, or any form of law and order situation. So that's the best thing that we can do to strengthen these three countries. This is for every country, especially for Saudi Arabia. But we know from a hadith that Constantinople, Turkey won't be with us anymore very soon. So the worst thing in such a scenario is your own people, they have their thoughts against the government. So this is for the Turkish people too. Never ever try to rebel against your government, no matter what they do. Don't obey them in the things a government, although no Islamic government in the world forces people to not practice Islam, the Muslim governments don't do that. But even if they do, they are so worse, they reach to the point even then, don't obey them in that specific thing only. And don't rebel against all of the laws. That's what Islam teaches us. So that's the best thing that we can do to strengthen all these countries. And inshallah, that's how we can postpone bad things that are going to come. Inshallah. And that's how, inshallah, we expect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy to fall upon us. Even if you're feeling very bad and not feeling good and we don't like our governments, we don't rebel against them. And that's the best thing. Allahu, Allahu.